shake up top. It's going to be hard to double team him from multiple angles.
It has been a terrific first half for Joel. 5 for 10. He has 11 points. And now with the free throw, make it 12. Sixers by 10. They have led virtually all the way. Pritchard for 3 from deep. Kept alive by the Celtics. Brown. Another offensive rebound.
He might as well take that shot, Marv. He went in there and got a tough rebound. He said, hey, let me get this shot up before Coach pulls me up. And again, look at Embiid on the post and the spacing. It's going to be so tough this year for teams to do that. Because this year, the Sixers are back, except they might have a little bit more power on the offensive end.
Play-in tournament. Philadelphia, meanwhile, shooting 55% from the field in this first half. And Joel Embiid has led the way. 14 points now for Embiid. Boston only at 34%, 11 for 32. And it's a 12-point lead for the Sixers. Williams diving for it, it's popped out of bounds. So the ball back to the Sixers.
Now that Embiid has kind of had his way, as you said, Marv, I'd like to see him in the post, and I'd like to see him with the live dribble and get other guys involved. He can hand off to them, set flare screens, pass on the other side. We know he can get his, but he has some other guys he has to get involved now. Maybe you want to get a rhythm getting them some buckets.
Tobias Harris not able to hit. We were talking earlier with Doc Rivers, and we asked about the combination of trying to run and also having Joel Embiid, who looks to play down low and grind it out. But he points out if you don't trap Embiid, he's going to score. We only saw them trap maybe once, maybe twice, and Embiid has been able to take advantage.
It was easy to trap him last year, but again, I know we all know about Steph. He has a brother, and they are the true Splash Brothers. Shout out to Thompson Goodwell. But Seth really can space the floor, and that's all really good players need, just space, because it keeps them comfortable, and you can't really double team. And by the way, Embiid being a great passer, he's going to welcome those double teams and get a few assists and maybe even some triple doubles.
Ojale able to hit Embiid on the move, and the ball slapped away, knocked out of bounds. Embiid is the high man with 14. He's hit 6 of 12 for the most part from the perimeter. And just drew the foul. Foul is called on Williams. Embiid, 81% at the line last season. The regular season will get underway December the 22nd. That's next Tuesday. Kevin Durant, Kyrie Irving, and the Nets hosting Steph Curry and company of the Warriors, followed by Kawhi Leonard and the Clippers going up against LeBron and the defending champion Lakers. Coverage of opening night presented by Kia, beginning at 5 Eastern Time right here on TNT. Point lead for the Sixers. They're smart. And the foul is called. You see Danny Green looking for a review.
Danny Green is saying, listen, I got an elbow. That was a smart play. High smart. Because he understands that when you get in that position, gonna put the refs in a tough spot right there. And he's trying to get the coach to review, but Dr. Sanders, this is a preseason game. A lot of tape to watch. Let's just keep going.
Be a little early, I think, to challenge at this point.
Yeah. Danny's fresh off a championship.
Early in the game.
yeah, exactly. Yeah. And early in the preseason.
So Smart able to take advantage, hits both. Sixers up by nine. Now both teams over the foul limit. Three-quarter jump by Curry is off. Tatum looking for a shot. Try to set him up on the screen.
Jalen has the most almost dunks posters on people of anyone because he attacks you hard, man. Oh, man.
Tatum just 2 for 7.
Jalen in the cocky back like that just a little bit too hard. He was trying to make sure that it went down over the 7-footer and not getting the finish.
Taylor just 1 of 9 from the field. Jason Tatum just 2 of 7.
Good defense right there by Javonte Green. If you want to earn time in preseason, you do it by doing the little things, executing on plays, running the correct routes, and then playing defense, fighting over screens to get some tough rebounds.
Led to the travel by Curry. This is Grant Williams, got the step.
Grant Williams really just showed me something. It's for a lot of you college players that are undersized, out of position, take a note from Grant Williams' playbook. He's improved his game. He's become a pretty good three-point shooter, solid with no defense on him if needed. But more importantly, he's been able to go out and guard three-point shooters and even try to stay with seven-footers that are much bigger than he is.
Embiid drew the foul. Grant Williams did go through, have led by as many as 12. They had led most of the way. They had 10 assists in the first quarter. And second quarter, no assists, 6 turnovers. But still have the lead up by 9 now. Sixers just 1 of 9 from three-point range, and they're hoping that their additions of Danny Green and Seth Curry certainly improve the three-point shooting as the season develops. And Jaylen Brown has had his shooting difficulties tonight.
Dribbles off the pick and roll and knocking it down.
And again, Brown comes up short. Harris going 1-on-3, had it knocked aside last touch by Tobias. Chris, the NBA competition committee voted unanimously the other day to expand active rosters on 8 days from 13 to 15, and the Board of Governors will vote on this in a couple of days. In light of COVID issues, it's very likely to be approved, I would think.
I would hope so. We've seen it in football with an extra man being added to the practice squad and even being able to be inserted up to just a few minutes before the game. I think we just have to be prepared that the only constant, and this is going to be changed, and I look forward to the NBA Board of Governors hopefully definitely improving that so that a lot of other young guys will get the chance. And for those young guys that are coming into the end of these bench in the roster, hopefully they realize that this is going to be a real opportunity and hopefully they take advantage of it.
Here's Teague able to drill it. Jeff Teague, who once the season starts, will be playing at the point with Kemba Walker sitting it out with the knee problems. Jeff Teague in his 12th season out of Wake Forest. Just under a minute left in the first half. Embiid unable to hit. But Embiid has been the story offensively for the Sixers here in the first half. As Jaylen Brown is fouled. Jalen looking at a 1-for-11 stat line in this first half.
It's time to do it. Get it out in the preseason.
Foul committed by MB. Jalen Brown coming off an outstanding season. And is usually so explosive going to the rim. Average 20 a game. Shot 38% from three, 6 rebounds a game. So Boston now with it 4 after trailing by as many as 12. Harris with the runner against the roll.
This is where you want to see the Celtics run something efficient for their best two players, whether Tatum or Brown. You know that you're going to spread the floor. T, the veteran guard, is going to get someone involved, but you just don't want them to be stagnant. Bad shots in the offensive. Speaking of stagnant, they
try to
with the bad shot at the offensive end. There you go.
Kept alive by the Celtics. Final seconds of the half. Here's Tatum on the drive. That is the end of the first half. Sixers with a 6-point lead over the Celtics. Sixers led by Embiid with 18 points. Halftime in Philadelphia.